Wait. Okay, very good morning to all of you, my dear students and my dear colleagues present over here. Actually, in the previous class, I have shown you how to represent the transient analysis of RL-RC circuit and as well as the RLC series resonance. Okay. And I have shared the recorded lecture and I am very happy and I will be very happy if you are able to show from the recorded lecture that you are able to show the RLC series resonance. So I am requesting Ishita to show the RLC series resonance in speech space. Okay, Ishita, show.
Yes, ma'am.
Oh. Okay, Ishita, present your screen and show. Yes.
So ma'am, this is a series RLC circuit where we have taken the resistance value to be 200 ohm, inductance to be 470 millihenry and capacitance to be 1 microfarad. As we know that in case of resonance, the capacitive reactance is equal to the inductive reactance, which is X equal to XL, which means omega C equal to 1 by omega L. And from here, we get the omega value to be 1 by LC, 1 by root over of LC. And we even know that the relation between omega and frequency is omega equal to 2 pi f. So now if we put the values, we get the resonant frequency to be 1 by 2 pi root over of LC. So like on putting these values in the equation, we get the resonant frequency to be around 232 hertz. And as we know that there is maximum current because Z is equal to R, like the impedance is equal to resistance, and Z is minimum, so the current will be maximum. So ma'am, this is my V sine oscillator. Over here, I've taken the values of DC to be 0, AC 5, V off is 0, V amplitude is 5 root 2, which is 7.07, and frequency is 1K. Now I'm saving these attributes.
Okay.
And after that, I went to the setup analysis. Over there, I've taken the AC sweep and I've selected the type to be linear. Since we know that the value of resonant frequency is 232 hertz, we have to select our range like that. So I've taken the minimum start frequency to be 10, end frequency to be 500, and the total points as 101. Now I'm saving it as well. And after that, when I simulate my circuit, I get this as my graph. Over here, I go to toggle cursor and point my point the resonant frequency.
Resonant frequency, yes.
The resonant frequency and at 232.143 hertz, I'm getting the value of maximum current at around 24.942 hertz. So I mark this, mark label. I go to mark label and mark it. And then, ma'am, after that, I remove the X grid and Y grid to make myself.
So I am interrupting, Ishita. This is 232.14. That is your resonant frequency. Yes. And under resonant frequency, the value of the current is 25 approx milliampere, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, continue, please.
Yes, ma'am. So, like after that, I remove the grids to make my graph more clear. And I give the labeling. Which is series RLC resonance, and the resonance frequency is 232 hertz. Then I save it, and after saving it, I'm getting this as my result.
Oh, very good. Okay, so what you have to do, Ishita and other students, and you have to do the calculation manually, and you have got the, I mean, resonant frequency from the graph, what Ishita has very nicely explained. So you will compare these two. If it is there is no error, then there is no error. Basically, you have to show the resonant frequency from the graph. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
I think it is clear to all of you. Anybody want to show, or I will show the next experiment. Basically, the RLC steady state value of the current voltage in case of RLC.
Keep. Okay, ma'am. Then I'll stop sharing.
Yeah. Anybody want to show?
Ma'am, I have done. If you want to see, then I can show.
Okay, jaldi jaldi karo, Ishita.
Okay.
Ishita. I'll even note down Ishita's roll number and name, okay?
Ma'am, I also did. After that, I will show it.
Okay, let her finish.
Ma'am, I forgot to unmute, so I had to stop presenting once.
Ma'am,
here is ma'am, here is the circuit where the R is 200. Ma'am, can you see?
Yeah. You can continue.
The resistance is 200 ohm and the L1 is 470 milli ohm and the
milli henry,
sorry ma'am, and the C
student, you are listening what Ikshita is telling, yes or no?
Yes ma'am.
Yes ma'am.
Because yes, she is showing it for you, not for me. You have to interact with her. If any problem is there, if she does any mistake, you will tell her, okay? Okay, continue.
Okay, ma'am. Ma'am, then the AC source, which is V sine, which is, I have taken the attributes to be DC is 0 and then AC is 5 and V amplitude is 7.07 and frequency is 1K and everything else is 0. And then I saved the attribute and okay. Then I have taken this current probe to show the current. And then I went to the setup analysis and then setup analysis. And then AC sweep where the total PTS is 101. And the starting frequency is 10 and the end frequency is 500 because it has to be more less than and more than 232, which is the frequency because the formula is 1 by frequency formula frequency is resonance frequency is 1 by root 1 by 2 pi root over LC with the value of L and C as these. Then I have to go to this simulate and then I have to
you did not save it.
Okay.
Save it.
Yes, now it is here. Then I have to go to this and probe cursor and put the value as 230, nearest to 232. So 232.284 is coming. So, and then I have to set this, write this value over here and remove these traces. Oh, I have to close this first. Then I have to do this properties.
Settings.
Settings, okay.
Settings.
Then AY X grid.
I have to remove in both the columns, none.
Oh, yes, I forgot. Okay, now it is done, and then I have to save it as a PDF. I'm done.
Okay, very good, Ipshita.
Thank you.
Now and I can share.
Who?
Now I can share. Nandini.
Yes, I also want
ma'am,
to share.
I also share too.
Somebody has.
Ma'am, I told.
Somebody you. Has told. Up.
Ma'am, will I share it?
Kumar Sovik.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, share.
Nandini, show koro. Oh,
show week korche Ali bhai. Show week
korche.
Sir, after this I will share.
Okay.
Ma'am, is it visible?
Yes, visible.
Yes, yes, visible.
Ma'am, here. Yes, ma'am, here that we have used that
first of all, tell what you are doing.
Ma'am, here we are finding that RNC series resonates.
Basically, want to find out the resonant frequency at which the current will be maximum, right?
Yes, 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 ma'am. Okay. Ma'am, here we have used that voltage oscillator. Ma'am, here the DC is value is 0, AC is 5, and V amplitude is 5 root 2, that is 7.07. Ma'am, and we have also used the resistance, that is 200 ohm. The inductor value is 470 millihenry, and the capacitor value is 1 microfarad. Ma'am, now we are going to the transient analysis, and here that AC sweep, we have selected the linear graph, and ma'am, the starting frequency will be less than, that is less than 232, that therefore I've given it 10, and the in frequency will be greater than 232, so it's coming to be 500. And ma'am, from the formula, that is frequency equal to 1 by 2 pi into root under of LC, so there the frequency is to be coming to be 232, approx 232 hertz. Now ma'am, I'm going through the analysis, and here and then the graph is coming, and I have to use this toggle cursor to select, and it's coming approximately, the frequency coming approximately to be 232.143 hertz, and I have to display the values. I'm selecting this, and the current is to be coming to be 24.942 milliampere. And ma'am, now I have to deselect this grid, so I'm going to the settings, and here I have to select this none option, ma'am. Now it is completed, and I have to save it, so I'm going to the file and print, and as I will be saving it as a PDF. So and ma'am, I saved it. Now ma'am, yeah. Will I show that PDF also?
Yeah.
Okay, ma'am.
Yeah, have you thickened it? Thicken the graph?
No, ma'am. That I forgot to thicken.
Okay, you'll do it. Okay. If you want it, you can do it.
Yes, ma'am. And this is the graph.
Yeah. Okay. Very nice. And have you put the name RLC series resonance, the title?
No, ma'am. That also I forget. Okay, ma'am. I will do it.
Everything you have forgot. Okay. No problem. Okay. Very explain. Okay, Shobhik, it's very good.
Thank you, ma'am.
I am very happy that you are able to show the resonant frequency from the graph with very nicely. Okay, nicely you are showing. Okay, so Ali bhai, KK dekhalo, Deep Narayan dekhiye, Shobhik
Kumar, 34, 35, 36, 39, 44 dekhalo.
Okay. So 38, Ipshita Mitra.
38.
Ma'am, now I can share.
Yes. Anandini is last one.
Share.
Okay, Anandini and Meghna, anybody is there to share? I'll go to the experiment.
Ma'am,
Nirmal, tale ajke ami ar experiment 6 dekhabo ki kore. Okay, continue.
Ma'am, are you able to see?
Yes.
So this is the RLC series resonant circuit in which I have taken the resistance to be 200 ohm, the inductance to be 470 millihenry, the capacitance to be 1 microfarad. I have also added a current probe so that we can see the graph. Here I have taken DC to be 0, AC to be 5, V off to be 0, V amplitude, VAMPL to be 7.07, and frequency to be 1K. and I have saved it. After that, I went to setup analysis, AC sweep, and AC sweep, I have selected the linear type. Here, sweep parameters, the total points are 101, start frequency is 10 and end frequency is 500, after which I'll close it. And after this, I'll simulate, I'll get this graph. In this graph, I've used toggle cursor and placed the point here. After this, I'll go to settings and
Joker Nandini, make the graph darker.
Yes, ma'am. I will remove this. Go to properties and width. Make the graph dark. By using this text label, I will enter the text label. RLC.
Series resonance, okay. And you can also write the, after giving a comma, you can write FR, right, 232 hertz. Have you calculated?
Yes, ma'am. By the formula 1 by 2 pi root over LC.
Okay, fine. Nandini, you can stop your sharing.
Okay, ma'am.
Very good.
Ma'am, now I can share.
Okay, after Meghna, I will show. Okay, Meghna is the last person who will share today. Okay, Meghna, share.
Okay,
do first.
Ma'am, is it visible? My screen is
visible.
Ma'am, so this is the series RLC circuit and our aim is to calculate the resonant frequency. This is V sine. This is a resistance of 200 ohm. This is inductance 470 millihenry. And this is a capacitance of 1 microfarad. And now we are clicking on V sine. And we are giving the values as DC equals to 0, AC equals to 5, V off equals to 0, V amplitude equals to 5 root 2, that is 7.07, frequency is 1 kilo ohm, TD equals to 0.
Frequency is what?
1 kilo ohm.
1 kilohertz, okay?
Oh, 1 kilohertz.
No need to say sorry, 1 kilohertz, okay.
Yes, Mrs. TD equals to 0.
By default, it will be TD 0. Okay, continue.
Yes, Miss. All others are 0 by default. Mm-hmm. And then we are clicking on OK. And then we are going on setup analysis. And
No. First of all, you have to calculate FR.
Yes, ma'am. FR, we have calculated by the formula FR equals to 1 by 2 pi root under LC. And by that, mm-hmm. we are getting it approximately 232 hertz. And after that, we are going to setup analysis and then AC sweep. AC sweep type is linear and the parameters we have chosen total points as 101 and start frequency is less than 232 hertz, that is 10, and end frequency is more than 232, that is 500.
Approx double.
Yes, ma'am. And after that, we went to simulate and then this is the graph. Yes. And now this frequency is approximately 232.461 hertz. And
how can you get the frequency? Just go to the toggle cursor.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. And follow the A1, 232. Yes, right. Yes, yes.
This one, after that, I clicked on mark label and this value is displayed. And this is the, after clicking on text label, I have inserted this text, RLC series resonance, resonant frequencies, 232 hertz. And now I will remove the grid. Okay. I have already thickened the graph, and now I will save it. File, then print. Okay.
Okay, Meghna, stop share. It is very nicely you have explained. I am very happy everybody is able to share it.
Okay,
ma'am. And to explain the RLC series resonance. Okay, stop share.
Ma'am, I'm so our
Nirmal, next class, okay?
Okay.
I want to explain the experiment number 6, okay? Okay, Nirmal, experiment 6, tell me to explain kore di. Presentation. So, go to the experiment 6, go to the manual, that is, what is your experiment number 6, students? What is your experiment number 6? Just note down in your copy, what I am writing, just follow me, okay? So, write down the date today. Is it visible to all of you, my dear students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So put the date today. Everybody will write in your copy. So experiment 6 is what?
Determination of the steady state response. Determination of the steady state response.
Sorry?
Determination
of what?
Steady state response
of what?
RLC circuit.
Okay, everybody will write in your copy steady state response of RLC series circuit. So this is our motto. Okay. So first of all, have you studied in your theory class the RLC series resonance and how can you determine the impedance, the actual impedance of the circuit, what is the phase lead, phase lag, what is capacitive, what is inductive, each and everything, have you studied in your theory class?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. So it will be helpful for you. In practical class, RLC, there is a supply, okay, this is RLC, fine. So obviously, the current is series circuit, the drop across R, that is VR, drop across L, that is VL, drop across C, that is VC. So if you want to draw the phasor diagram, what will happen? So this is actually VR and this is VL and it will be downwards, that is VC. Why? Because after across the inductance, the drop is basically what? J omega L. And across C, the VC equal to 1 by J omega C. Okay. So you can write it like this. J divided by J into J into omega C. That is J multiply and divide. Okay. So J square means minus, it will be J by minus omega C. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So if the inductive drop is upward, because in case of, in this is basically in case of inductive circuit, the voltage leads the current, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Voltage leads the current. If it is I, if it is V, L, then it is 90 degree. In voltage leads the current. But in case of inductive circuit, current lead voltage. Do you remember?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Current lead voltage. Okay. So on the basis of the current leading or lagging with respect to voltage, you will tell it is lagging or leading. So in case of inductive voltage, the current lags the inductive voltage, current lag. So it is called the lagging power factor, right? You remember this. Yes. And in case of capacitance, the current leads the voltage. So it is
leading power factor.
Okay. So if you subtract VL and VC, so this is like this. Say this is like this VL, VC. So it will be what? Say like this. So you can tell it VL minus VC. Am I correct?
Yes, ma'am.
So basically what I want to say, if this is O, this is A, this is B, then what is the, they say this is D, okay? So V equal to what? I R square plus IXL minus IXC root of square that root. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
This is V square, I mean VR square, and this is VL minus VC, the mod, the whole square, root of that. And what is I? I that is equal to V divided by root of R square plus XL minus XC mod of that, basically. Might be XL greater compared to XC. So you have to consider the mod of that. Right, Naishita?
Yes, ma'am. Ishita? Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is represented by V by Z. So what is Z? Z means actually root of R square plus XL minus XC whole square. Okay. So, say this is the net reactance, X. So, X will be XL minus XC whole square. So, what is happening here? Current equal to this, you have got it. And now, cos phi equal to what? If this is phi, cos phi is equal to what?
R by Z.
Okay. So Z equal to, already I have told, root of R square plus X square. X equal to what? XL minus XC. Okay. So you have to do a problem. Okay. And that problem, you will do it in virtual and you can do it actually from the lab also. Okay. So just I'm file, new, save, RLC. RLC circuit. Today is 15th, 12th. Okay, now come to a problem. Say this is 20 ohm this is 0.2 henry. It will be inductance. I'm sorry. And this is a capacitance, okay? Supply is there. Capacitance value, say 100 microfarad. So, the problem is that, this is the problem. Write down the problem. A resistance of 20 ohm, 0.2 henry inductance and a capacitance of 100 microfarad are connected in series across 220 volt 50 hertz supply. Okay? Then determine the following parameters like impedance, current, VR, VL, VC, power in watt and V ampere, VA, and power factor, angle. Theek hai? So how can you do all these things? First of all, what is Excel?
Ma'am,
Excel,
can you repeat? Can you repeat what we have to find?
You will go through the record, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Achha, Excel is equal to
omega
L. So this is 2 pi XL, that is equal to 2 pi omega is equal to
frequency 2 pi f. Into,
yeah. So what is the value? 2 pi into f equal to
50
what?
50 hertz.
62.83.
0.2.
Yes, ma'am. It's
62.83. So answer is
62.3 ohm. Yes,
ma'am. Right? And C is equal to what? 100 microfarad. So what is XC? XC is equal to what? 1 by omega C. So put the value 1 by 2 pi F into C. So what you have to put? 2 pi into F equal to what? 50. Into C is equal to what? 100 microfarad. Mind it. So it will be 10 to the power minus 6. Right now?
Yes, ma'am.
So XC will be approximately
31.83.
Very good. 31.83. As somebody has told, might 32. Be Ishita, 32 yes, ohm. Okay? Now, you have got XL and XC. So, this is inductive or capacitive? Which is dominating here? Inductive, right?
Inductive.
So, X is equal to what? XL minus XC. So, that will be 63 minus 32. Approx. It is 31 ohm. So it is inductive, not capacitive. So lagging power factor, because voltage will lead the current, current will lag the voltage. Okay. Now come to Z. Z is equal to what? Bolo.
2 to the power of R square plus XL minus
R square.
Right. R square plus XL minus XC whole square. So what will be the value?
Ma'am, 4.
What is R?
20.
20 square plus yeah. What?
31 square.
Very good.
31 square.
31 square. This is 20. Yes. So what will be the value?
36.89. 37 almost.
Okay, very good. So what is I? What Ipshita has told me, ma'am, what to do? You have to calculate Z. Current. That is equal to what?
V by Z. Yes, sir.
That is 220 by 37. Fine. So this is approx what? Bala, bala. What is the value? Ishita?
5.94.
Exactly. Thank you. 5.9. And what is VR?
6.
That is IR.
Yes.
Sir. That is equal to what?
And ma'am,
6 into
120.
That is 120 volt. Fine.
120.
What is VL? jaldi bolo what is
I
vl
excel
excel
into I into excel I.
That is what 63
into
6 into 63 that is equal to 378 volt approx.
Yes,
what is vc
I into xc
6 into
32
what is the value
192
volt
192
now come to power in volt ampere what will be the value 6 into what 220
yes ma'am
this is 220 and this is 6 so what will be the value
1320
volt ampere okay yes, now power in watt now power factor will come into the field so power in watt what will be the value 6 into 220 into power factor what is the power factor value
r by z
so what is power factor power factor that is equal to cos phi that is equal to what r by z that is equal to what
20
divided by
37
so this is 0.54 so what is phi cos inverse 0.54 then give me the answer what is phi
57.3 degree ma'am
57.32 degree approx thank you so power in watt what will be the answer power in watt that will be equal to what 6 into
or 220
220
into
57 0.54 yes and that will be 713.5 watt approx 713 or 4 watt okay
yes ma'am
okay so this is our total calculation how can you do all these things and your question is that ma'am why are you showing all these things because when we'll go to the experiment number 6 you have to do manually and you have to do experimentally that is virtual experiment and you have to do manually with the same parameters and you have to compare okay now go to the experiment
ma'am I have a question
what question
ma'am in the last experiment capacitor it was UF 1 UF so
you
what
miss
was
micro
you miss micro
oh okay ma'am thank you ma'am
yeah if there is n this is nano that is 10 to the power minus 9
okay ma'am
okay now if sita is it okay
yes ma'am
okay you are very good student and other students you are not responding nandini dipnarayan are you listening are you writing
yes ma'am
yes ma'am
yes ma'am
everybody
yes,
will write so go to the experiment 6 that is virtual lab link this is the link can I share the link in your chat box
yes ma'am
yes ma'am
control c and when I am sharing the link in the chat box Ishita you will share it in your WhatsApp group okay
okay ma'am
control v where is it this is the link of your experiment number 6 please share it in your WhatsApp group everybody will get it after finishing the class okay so this is your experiment number 6 that is virtual definitely actual lab is also there that is physical lab is also there when you go to the college or if it is possible then sir will show you from the lab later on okay first of all see it so what to do this is RLC circuit analysis from this circuit you will be able to show the steady state analysis of RLC series circuit so this is obviously RLC series circuit having a AC voltage source okay and having particular frequency say V already all these things I have explained yes or no
yes ma'am
yes,
all
ma'am.
These things I have explained V equal to IR j omega I mean XL into I 1 by j omega c everything I have explained okay so VL that is equal to j I XL whatever may be and it has taken that I is common, R plus j omega L plus 1 by j omega C. I think it will be helpful for you. And angle is tan inverse this. Okay. So if you go through the record after finishing the class, and if you follow the class, it will be clear to all of you how can you do it. So already this phasor diagram I have also explained, right? This is if this is current and the I into R, that is the VR will be in the same phase with the current right now. And VL, yes, already I have told that voltage, mm-hmm, in case of inductive voltage is in 90 degree phase with the current. So it will be here, okay. And capacitive, that will be below. Yeah. This is capacitive circuit because it is dominating. Capacitive drop is dominating, and it is inductive because inductive drop is dominating. So I think up to this theory portion is clear. Now come to the simulator, okay? So click the simulator and come to the click to perform the experiment, okay? So what to do? Everything is written over there. Close the circuit, close the switch, set input voltage, Vin, 220 volt, you'll do it. Set power supply, you'll do it. So what to do? Close the switch, set input voltage, Vin, 220 volt. Switch ke close kore dao, close, okay. Set the power, that is input voltage, 220, okay. So go there. 220, is it correct? 220 volt. This is also given 50 hertz. So adjust the voltage across the circuit VS. So what to do? This is the knob. This is the like a probe. Okay. Say this is 0.9. So if it is 0.9, the VS will be what? This is basically variac. Okay. So 220 into 0.9, that will be the value. What will be the value? Bolo.
220
into 0.9. 198. 198. Okay. If it is 0.7, what will happen? That is 70. And then key bolo, just listen. VS, that is 70. So come here, 0.70. Like this, you will do it, okay? So if, I'm sorry, this if it is 0.70, then you will be able to get the VS. In this way, you will set it. That is, adjust the voltage across the VS, 70 volt. 70 volt means basically it wants to say that you have to put here 0.7 and note the current and you will do it. All these things you have to follow, okay? Okay, just let me finish. Let me finish. I think it will be clear. Adjust the rheostat for several settings of the repeat step 2. This rheostat you have to adjust just using this probe, okay? And adjust the, okay, now come to capacitance 0, 140 and 70. Say 0, 0. Come capacitance 0. So first of all, we have to check one thing. It will be 0.7. If it is 0.7, then it, what will be the value?
154.
Yeah. So come here, 0.7. Now is it correct? 0.7.
Yes,
note down kora now. It will be 0.7 and C will be 70 microfarad. Where is C? This is C. 70 microfarad. 70 microfarad, okay. Now, L will be 60 millihenry. 60 millihenry is there. And R is equal to 50 ohm. Come here. R is equal to 50 ohm. So this is the maximum. So what I have written over, what I have selected here, R is equal to 50 ohm, C is equal to 70 microfarad, and L equals to 60 millihenry. And supply voltage 220/50, and you have to put 0.7. So at this situation, run it. That is on the circuit. So if you run it, so all this data is here. Okay, all this data are here, and so fill the table. Okay, so power supply 155. Tomra ki peyechilo 154. Okay, now do the calculation. Current. You have to do the manually, and in the next class I will share. I will see that you have to do the manually because you will follow the recorded lecture. I think it will be very clear how to do the manually. Okay, I mean already ki dekhiyechi. In case of RLC series circuit, I have taken the R value
20.
R value 20 ohm, L 0.2 Henry and C 100 microfarad. You have done it. Okay. Now in this experiment, R is 50 ohm, L is what? 60 millihenry, C is 70 microfarad. On the basis of this, you have to do the calculation manually. And from the table, you have to compare this. Okay. So up to this, is it clear to all of you? And somebody was asking a question. If anybody has any question, can ask.
No, ma'am, clear.
I know it is clear.
Ma'am, then we have to find the error.
So definitely you will get the table, okay? You will get the table and you will do the calculation first in the way which I have told you, right? And go to the virtual lab link and do the, and A should A set tai korbe. Kon set bollam? This
151.
Set. This is 0.7. This is 220. This is 50. This is 50, this is 60, this is 70. For all these parameters, you have to do this calculation manually and you will do the check the error. So there will be error. Error is power supply, error is current, error will be power, error will be VR, VL, VC, everything. There will be error. What is the error? You have to do the calculation. Okay. First of all, do the calculation. You have to determine the current, right now?
Yes, ma'am.
So I think everything is clear to all of you. So after 6 experiment, it is clear. Okay. Acha car ekta ki problem hochhilo bolchile?
Ha ma'am. Dekhabo.
Bolo.
Oi piece by piece mane circuit draw korchhilam tarpor simulate korar shomoy kono graph show hochhilo na.
Definitely you have done some problem.
Dekhabo ekbar screen share koro.
Yeah, sure.